Last time on Icon TV, this just might be the thing ICX hodlers have been waiting for. South Korea is finally retiring their decades-old online ID security system. The system was first introduced in 1999 and has reigned as the country's dominant security platform for online transactions and identity checks. 21 years later, South Korea's public certification system will meet its demise after the Electronic Signature Act was passed by Congress. The new law will go into effect in November of 2020. The only question is, who or what is going to replace the old system? But if you start connecting the dots, a blockchain-based ID system appears to be the obvious choice.
Mineable presents Icon TV.
Hi, this is David from P-Rep Team Mineable. Make sure you subscribe and click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos. Your phone, computer, and the internet. These technologies have become an irreplaceable part of our interconnected society. Integration so seamless that we don't even notice we're using them. When people think of blockchain technology, they think of digital payments, speculation. But blockchain is capable of so much more. And ICON is one of the first projects to tap into that potential. Something that is far beyond speculation. The potential of integrating blockchain technology into the everyday lives of billions of people globally. That is the future ICON is building. Life meets blockchain. If there's a lesson to be learned from 2020 and the 6 months of global lockdown, it is the pace at which the world has gone digital, with many companies and individuals constantly looking to exchange information securely. Blockchain adoption was inevitable. This is where ICON comes in. In 2017, the ICON project started out with the goal of connecting Korea and, ultimately, hyper-connecting the world. Fast forward to 2020, they've managed to build a vast network of partnerships with some of the largest companies in the world, Korea's largest banks, and key government entities, including the government of Seoul. But that was just the beginning. What comes next is some of the biggest news for any crypto project: true mass adoption. It's official. MyID has launched and it came out guns blazing. Welcome to Jeju Island, better known as the Hawaii of South Korea. It's South Korea's most popular tourist destination and is visited by 15 million tourists every year. In fact, it's one of the busiest airport routes in the world. Jeju Island has taken strong measures to prevent the spread of COVID-19. They've collaborated with ICON Loop to develop a first-of-its-kind blockchain application and provide private and secure COVID contact tracing to the island's 15 million annual visitors. When visitors arrive on Jeju Island, they will download a mobile app to check into tourist destinations using a QR code. Their data will then be secured on the blockchain and only accessed in the case of COVID-19 contact. The app uses the ICON public blockchain for mobile authentication. That means 15 million people will be using ICX every time they visit the island and download the application. This is the first major adoption of a public chain product by a major government entity. That in itself is revolutionary. Just when you thought it couldn't get more bullish, 1 week after the launch of MyID, the second largest bank in Korea introduced a product that integrates ICON's MyID into their native banking application. Yes, you've heard that right. ICX has been integrated with one of the largest banks in South Korea. Here's why this is a game changer. Shinhan is Korea's second largest commercial bank with $375 billion in assets and 18 million customers. These 18 million South Korean customers will soon be able to remotely open bank accounts by only using their smartphones via ICON Loop's MyID. This verification verification process will leverage both the private chain and ICON's public blockchain. In other words, ICX will be used by Shinhan's 18 million customer base without them even knowing it. That is another perfect example of true mass adoption. ICON has spent years building connections between its private and public network, and we're finally starting to see real-life examples of what makes the synergy between ICON Loop and ICON so powerful. These partnerships will give even more legitimacy to ICON's public network and create a snowball effect of even more private businesses wanting to join the network. Currently, ICON Loop's MyID Alliance has over 70 members, consisting of companies like Samsung Electronics, banks, securities firms, local governments, e-commerce companies, and manufacturers. This was just the first MyID integration from its 70-plus Alliance partners. One by one, every company in MyID Alliance will be connected. For ICON, what we've seen so far was just the tip of the iceberg. Thank you for watching this episode of ICON TV. Make sure you subscribe and like this video. And if you're an ICONist, make sure you show your support and vote for Mineable P-Rep. Every vote counts. See you next time. Mineable out.